Students, welcome to our civics class. In the last video, we had completed our chapter 2 of civics, the Indian Parliament. Today, we begin a new chapter of civics, chapter 3, the Union Executive. Students, this is the last chapter for semester portion. Let's quickly go through the semester portion of history and civics. Moving on to our third chapter now, the Union Executive. In this chapter, we will cover the following points. We will understand the structure of the union government, president, elections of president, function, powers of president, prime minister and council of ministers, and how parliament keeps checks over council of ministers. So let's get started with the third chapter, the union executive. Students, in this chapter, in this video today, we will cover the following points: structure of union government, president, elections of president, powers or functions of president, prime minister and council of ministers. So let's get started with the today's chapter, the union executive. Structure of the union government. Union government means the central government. Students, you have to remember, our India has two types of government: central government, also called as union government, and state government. Union government means that government that takes care of the entire country of India is called as central government. Whereas state government means all the states in India have different governments. For example, state government of Maharashtra, state government of Goa, state government of Kerala. Those are called as the state government. So union government means the central government. Government that functions for the entire country of India is called as union government or the central government. Today we will understand the structure or how the union government is made. Now there are two important parts of union government: legislature and the executive. We have learned that legislature is something that makes laws. In legislature, again, you have Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and executive, you have prime minister and council of ministers. Students, in the previous videos, previous chapters, we have understood the meaning of legislature. Legislature is the department of the government that makes laws. Similarly, executive are the people or department that makes people follow the rules and laws. Those are called as the executive. The last chapter, we learned how the laws are made. It is made by the houses like Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Therefore, they come under the legislature, the people who make laws. Similarly, executive means the people who help or actually make people of India follow rules and laws are called as executive, which is done by the prime minister and council of ministers. We'll understand the meaning of council of ministers in the upcoming slides. Executive is a part of legislature. Without legislature, executive cannot take place, and executive is the most important part of the legislature. India's union executive compromises of president, prime minister and council of ministers. In chapter 1, we learned about the two systems of government, parliamentary system and presidential system. In that, we learned that India is a country that follows the parliament system of government. That means India has a prime minister, president and council of ministers. So the department, union executive, the department that works for the entire country, which helps people follow all the rules and laws, are called as union executive of India, which consists of president, prime minister and council of ministers. President, he is called as the supreme head of the country. President is the first citizen of India and also the supreme head of the country. Government carries its function in the name of the president. In reality, it is prime minister and council of ministers who run the country. You have to understand that president is the first citizen and the head of the country. There is no one above president in our country. All the work of the government is carried under the circumstances and function of the president. But actually, it is the prime minister and council of ministers who run the country. Council of ministers are the various ministers appointed by the prime minister to take care of various departments in our country. For example, health minister, various chief ministers of our states. Then you have education minister, defense minister. These are called as a council of ministers. The cabinet of the parliament is called as council of ministers. President is called as a constitutional head and prime minister is called as the executive head. That means president is said to be the constitutional head, means it is the responsibility of the president to make sure that the country, his country, is ruling or running according to the constitution of that country. And it is the duty of the president to make sure all the rules and laws are followed. Therefore, he is called as the executive head. So, president is called as the constitutional head. That means he has to make sure that the prime minister is running the country based on the constitution, and prime minister is called the executive head because it is the duty of the prime minister to make people of India follow all the rules and laws. Now, elections of the president. Indirectly elected. Now, have you ever heard that there is an election in India where we are electing the president? No. President of India is elected indirectly by the people of India. Common people do not vote for the elections of the president. The group of parliamentarians and members of state legislature is known as electoral college. Now, in the parliament, there is a department, there is a committee or group of members who are specifically appointed to appoint the president of the country, and that is called as electoral college. Now, the tenure of the president is 5 years. That means the president can remain on the post for maximum 5 years. He has to be citizen of India and complete 30 years of his age. President takes oath to run the country as per the constitution. As we learned just now, president is said to be the constitutional head. That means it is the foremost responsibility of the president to make sure that the country of India is run under or as per the constitution. Therefore, whenever he is appointed as the president of the country, he takes an oath. Oath is a promise that he will run the country as per the constitution. Responsibility of protecting the constitution is shouldered by the president. Now, there is something called as process of impeachment. Act of president violates constitution. Parliament removes the post of president. Now, in any circumstances, if the president is found not doing his job properly, or he is under corruption, or he is cheating other people, he is not doing his work properly, the parliament means the two houses, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, Council of Ministers, Prime Minister, they have the total right to take away the president out of his post. That is called as process of impeachment. Now, that takes place only when the resolution is passed by both the houses of the parliament. Any one person thinking that this president is not doing the work properly, he could be taken out from the post, is not possible. It is a long procedure where if the president is found not doing his job properly, then the majority of the people of the houses should pass that resolution, and only then he can be taken out from the post. That is called as process of impeachment. To take out a president from his post before 5 years is called as process of impeachment. And in absence of president, the vice president of India carries the functions of the president. Powers and functions of the president. Now, as a president of India, the foremost power is summons meetings of the parliament. It is the most important power of the president to appoint meetings of the parliament. Next is signs bill to make a law. We learned in the previous chapter, any new rule or law has to become or has to be made in India, it is first called as bill or rough draft. It becomes a law only and after the signature of the president. So it is the important duty of the president to sign the bill to convert it into a law. Third is appoints prime minister and council of ministers. Now, after the president is appointed, it is the duty of him to appoint the prime minister and also the council of ministers. Ministers appointed to the various departments are called as council of ministers. appoint judges of Supreme and High Court. The most important duty of the president is to appoint the judges of Supreme Court and the High Court. Next is decisions of war and peace. It is the most important duty of the president to take decisions in terms of war and peace. Now, today's situation, we normally don't find any war, but if any war takes place, the decisions are to be taken by the president of India. Judicial powers. Now, the most important power of the president is judicial powers. For instance, the president has the power to reduce the punishment or increase the punishment which are given by the judges of Supreme and the High Court. Declare emergency. Emergency in terms of, now there are three types of emergencies which could be declared in India. First is national, state and financial. That means if any country of India experiences the national emergency, it is the duty of the president to declare national emergency. That country of India requires national support for various countries of the world. It is declared by the president. State emergency, if any state in India is facing severe problems, it is the duty of the president to declare state emergency. Ask for help from the various countries of the world. And third is financial emergency. If the country of India is facing very severe financial problems, money problems, it is declared by the as financial emergency. Prime Minister and Council of Ministers, head of political party winning the elections becomes the Prime Minister. Now we have learned how the Prime Minister is elected. Every 5 years, election takes place of the political parties, and the political party which get maximum votes, head of that political party is appointed as the Prime Minister of India under the guidance of President. Prime Minister and Council of Ministers should be the members of the Parliament. Now there are some criteria to become the Prime Minister. He has to be the member of the Parliament. Executive powers are with the Prime Minister and Council of Ministers. We learned Prime Minister is called executive head. That means it is the responsibility of the Prime Minister to make sure that all the new rules and laws are followed in the country of India along with the help of the Council of Ministers. Functions of Prime Minister. The most important function of the Prime Minister is formation of Council of Ministers. As we told just now, the Prime Minister gets selected, he appoints the various Council of Ministers. Department Ministers, Health Minister, Education Minister is called as Council of Ministers. Next is allotting portfolios. Portfolios means over here when the ministers are appointed, each of them are given various department. For example, Minister A is given Health Department, Minister B is given Education Department. That is called as portfolios. Allotment of work is called as portfolios. Third is meetings of Council of Ministers. In the Parliament, the meetings of Council of Ministers is taken under the guidance of the Prime Minister. Fourth is coordinate and supervise the work of Council of Ministers. It is the duty of the Prime Minister to make sure that all the Council of Ministers are doing their work properly. The Chief Ministers, the Health Minister, Department, Education Minister, each of them, it is the responsibility of the Prime Minister to coordinate and supervise the work of the Council of Ministers. To see if they are doing their work properly or no is the most important function of the Prime Minister because he has appointed them. And fifth is raise image of country and support the victims. It is the most important duty of the Prime Minister to see that the country of India's image, it is a duty of the Prime Minister to see that India develops and does not remain a developing or underdeveloped country, and also support the victims. Victims are the people who faced various problems in their life. They could be any people who does not have any food to eat, or they have faced any natural calamities. Those are called as victims. So the duty of the Prime Minister to help the people who have gone through very severe problems in their life. So let's summarize what we have learned. We learned in the video structure of the Union Government, President, elections, how it takes place, functions, Prime Ministers. Students, I hope the video is clear to you. Please watch the video and solve the assignment. The next part of the lesson I'll teach in the next video. Please solve the assignment. Assignment solving will carry marks. Thank you.